gonna be doing a documentary on changing a beta tank. As you can see, she's ready to come out. We'll be doing a complete water change. If you notice the built-in aquarium that's been in there for at least about a week or so, I thought I could make survive till Monday, but apparently not, so I had to go to PetSmart to get some beta conditioner. You notice right here, the best quality stuff for a beta fish. Alright, be back soon. Alright, and we're back. Sorry for the short delay. I had to unplug the heater here. At least a couple of minutes for it to cool down. As you can see, I'm showing you the cord here. Okay, move that out of the way. I discovered the best way to remove the beta from the tank is not use the net because it caused a lot of stress on the fish. A method I learned reading off the internet is to take a cup and try to catch the fish in the actual cup. If she's going to actually go in there. Well, we actually want to try to swim in there. Rather than try to catch her. You may have noticed she tried to bite my finger. Just a little bit of a method I like use the feeder. Where did I put that food? Seems I must have moved it out of the way. Anyway, this is one little piece of food here. It's a pellet. She gets to eat that right now. Okay, you can see she's like safe and secure in this little cup. She actually don't like it in there anymore. When I first bought her at Walmart, that's the only reality she knew. But since being moved into bigger aquariums, she's actually a little bit, spoiled. This is the 3-gallon tank, by the way. We're using. Ain't that right, Roxy? Well, let's move you out of the way so I can clean your home. I'll put her over here, right by the conditioner. She can watch as we, empty the aquarium. You may notice, this pump, I bought this off eBay. If you watch, we can begin to empty the tank. I have a bucket over here on the left side that you can't apparently see. Just so you don't think I'm like dumping the water onto the floor here. It's coming up onto this side, going straight into the bucket. Yeah, man, there's a lot of garbage in here. Move this down a little bit more. You can like, see there's a big rocks. I choose to have big rocks because it's easier to clean. The beta fish, if a piece of food falls to the bottom, I can easily catch it with my dropper. Well, this chrome hasn't been changed in 2 weeks. Last week was half a water change, and the week before that was a full water change. Alright, aquarium's to the point where I just want to pick it up, take it to the bathroom, and dump down the tub. Which I'm going to do right now. Do the same with the pump so it can dry off. We'll be right back. And we're back. I just completed emptying the tank, cleaning out the sides, getting rid of all that gunk and such. I don't have the water changer ready yet, but I plan to have it soon. Now, if you notice right here, this is the heater I use for the Betta tank. Set racks, let me move ya. Okay. Now, I don't normally take the heater out when I clean the tank, but I thought I'd do it this time around to show how I install it. It's on the bottom here. I use these two suction cups to keep it in place. Otherwise, of course, it's going to float to the top. But, sector, I can see the heater is installed. Oh, there we go. Camera angles always have different positions. Okay, box. I didn't, sterilize them as much. I tried to keep as much good bacteria on them as possible. I just washed them out to get rid of any unwanted derbies. Don't want that in any new polluted water, you understand? Now the heater's been repositioned. Okay, I found the little light that tells us if it's on heating or not. Usually want that to tell you if it's going or not, but before I forget, you never want to plug in a heater if there's no water. Otherwise, the pressure might burn out the heater. But it's never happened, so not too concerned. I'm always careful with that. Okay, let me reposition the camera here again. Now, I'm going to take the bucket here. I got two plants in. Plants ready for the Betta tank. Once the Betta's out of the way, I position the rocks. They're in just the right angle. Look all nice and pretty. I also put the one with the flower back here. And the big, cool plant where she can swim around, right in that area. Now what I'm going to go do is go refill this bucket with some nice warm water to the Betta temperature. It's a little cold, but not too bad. I think she's doing okay. Oh yeah, I just looked at her, she did a little drop in there, nothing to be too alarmed about, let my little fishy Roxy entertain ya while I go fill this water bucket.